So I want to implement a 4-variable truth table using an 8 over 1 mux. So 8 over 1 mux has 8 inputs, 1 output, and 3 select pins. The 3 select pins select which input goes to the output. So when selects are 0, the I0 goes to the output, which is, let's say, whatever, O. And then when S2 is 0, S1 is 1, S0 is 1, that means the third one. So that will, I2 will go to the output. So like that. So this one, these select pins will select which input goes to the output. Now, for a 4-variable truth table, there are 16 inputs. So I want to implement this one using this 8 over 1 mux. So first, what I will do, I will select the 3 lower significant bits of the inputs and connect them to the select pins. So B is the of these three, B is the highest significance. So B goes to S2, C goes to S1, and D goes to S0, like that. Now, what will happen as BCD change, the input will go according to the output. So when BCD is 0, either this one or this one will be selected. So we can divide the truth table into two parts. In these two parts, here BCD change from 0 to 1, 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1, that is 0 to 7. Similarly, for this, the next part, again, BCD change from 0 to 7, 0, 0, 0, then up to 1, 1, 1, like that. The only change between these two, the only difference between these two part of the truth table is A is 0 here and A is 1 here. And this A, either the A or A bar or 1 or 0, I will connect to the inputs. Let's see how I can do that so that the function is implemented. So when BCD is 0, this input will go to the output. Now I look at the truth table and see for BCD 0, what are the inputs and outputs. So when BCD is 0, here the input is 1, the output is 1, input is 0, and here the output is 1, input is 0. For BCD this part, the output is 1, the input is 0. That means the input has changed. And here, the input is 1, output is 0. So in both cases, the input is inverted. Whatever the input is, the output is inverted. It's the opposite. So I will connect A bar here. That means when BCD is 0, 0, 0, if A is 0, the output will be 1. If A is 1, the output will be 0. Like that. Similarly, now I will go to the next one, which is when BCD is 0, 0, 1. That means this one will be selected, which is I1. Now in the truth table, I look here and here. So this one and this one. And I can see that when input is 0, the output is also 0. And here when input is 1, the output is 1. So whatever is the input is going to the output. So I will write just A here. No bar there. Now I will move on to the third one. So that is when 0, 1, 0, that means that will select I2, and I0, 1, 0 is here. So I can see input is 0, output is 1. And for this one, for this, the second part of the truth table, or the bottom part of the truth table, when input is 1, output is 1. So basically, when input is 0, output is 1. When input is 1, output is 1. Basically, the output is not changing. It's 1. So I will just connect 1 here. Now going to the fourth one, which is 0, 1, 1. This one here, 0, 1, 1. And this one here, 0, 1, 1. I can see that for 0, 1, 1, input is 0, output is 1. And for this part, the input is 1, output is 0. So it's again inverting. The input is 0 here, output is 1 here, and the input is 1 here, output is 0 here. So it's inverting, so A bar. Now going to the fourth one, which is 1, 0, 0. This one. And I can see when input is 0, output is 0. Here it's also 0, sorry. And this one, input is 1, output is 1. So basically the output is following the input. When 0 here, 0 here. When 1 here, 1 here. So it's just A. Now moving to the next one, it's a 1 there. So 101, which is the fifth one, that is, it will be I4 here. This one was I3, I'm not writing anymore. I5, then I6, somewhere I missed the I6 probably. Actually, this one is I3, sorry, and this one will be I4. So basically just the right order. Basically, it's just increasing downwards. So this one is I3, this one is I3, this one is I4, I5, I6 and I7. So now I am looking at I4, which is this one. So I4, that is 101. So that one is I5 101. So when I'm looking at 101, this is 0 here and this one is 1 here, and for this one, this is 1 here, this is 0 here. So again, that's inverting. So I5 will be A bar. And the last two, the second last one is 110. When I'm looking at 110 here, I can see 0 here and 0 here as well. And when I'm looking here, it is 1 here and 1 here. That means whatever is the input is going to the output. That means that will be again A, which is the I6. And finally, the last one, I7, I can see it is 0 here, 0 here, and 1 here, 1 here. That means it is again A. So basically, let's forget this part because I have messed up somewhere. So this is I0, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I6 and I7. And the procedure is as I described. It will depend on the, we will have to divide the truth table into two parts, and just looking at it from observation, we have to select the inputs according to the most significant bit. Sometimes it will be the most significant bit itself, sometimes it's inverted input, or sometimes it can be 0 or 1 if the output doesn't change. If it stays 0, we can just connect 0 to the input, and if it is 1, we can connect 1. So basically that's the procedure. I know it's a bit clumsy, but I hope it's understandable.